myself Giridhar Jain, Assistant Professor in Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today, I am going to explain single phase full wave control rectifier with RL load. Learning outcomes of this session are: at the end of the session, students will be able to explain waveforms for full wave control rectifier with RL load. And second outcome is students will be able to derive expression for load voltage for the above converter. Contents of the session are circuit diagram and waveforms for the converter, circuit explanation, and derivation of average load voltage. Figure A shows the circuit diagram, and the figure B is the equivalent circuit. Now if we look at figure A, that is circuit diagram, the input is applied through a center tap transformer. Primary is fed with 230 volt AC. This is secondary is center tap. Point A, N is center tap, and this is another is B. Now T1 and T2 are the two SCRs connected as shown in circuit. Cathode of two SCRs connected together, and from that point a load is connected, RL load is connected between this point and the center tap of the secondary of center tap transformer as shown in circuit. And in the equivalent circuit, VAN and VBN are shown as a two sources. This is thyristor SCR T1 and SCR T2, and this is load. Now circuit operation: when VAN is positive, SCR T1 is forward bias and T2 is reverse bias. Because this is a center tap secondary, VAN and VBN are 180 degree out of phase. That is specialty of center tap transformer. Therefore, in positive half cycle of input, SCR T1 can conduct and SCR T2 is reverse bias. Similarly, in negative half cycle of input, VAN is negative, therefore SCR T1 will be reverse bias and T2 will be forward bias, which can conduct if firing pulse is applied. Now let us understand the circuit operation in detail with the help of waveforms. Now this figure shows the waveforms for input. This is the input sine of VAN. This is VBN. So VAN and VBN are 180 degree out of phase as shown in figure. This is the waveform for load voltage for continuous current mode. This is waveform for load current. This is waveform for load current for discontinuous current mode. And this is load voltage waveform for discontinuous current mode. Now here question arises in mind is that what is a continuous and discontinuous current mode? Now for RL load, when inductance is sufficiently large so that load current is continuous, means load current is always greater than holding current of the SCR, therefore SCR will continue to conduct till another SCR is fired. Now this is continuous current mode. And for discontinuous current mode, the load inductance is not sufficiently large so as to maintain the continuous load current. That is, for some part of the output, the load current is zero. So in positive half cycle of input, SCR T1 is triggered at firing angle alpha. So it will conduct from this point, and the output is part of input voltage, neglecting potential drop across SCR. At zero cross of line, we think the load current will become zero, but due to highly inductive load, it will not become zero. And SCR1 will continue to conduct in the negative half cycle of input. So input voltage reverses polarity after this zero crossover, but load current is still positive. Therefore, load voltage will be the negative voltage, and SCR1 will continue to conduct till SCR2 is triggered by application of positive gate pulse at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha. So at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, SCR T2 will conduct, which will apply reverse voltage across conducting SCR T1 and turn it off immediately by natural commutation. Then SCR2 will continue to conduct till SCR1 is triggered again at omega t is equal to 2 pi plus alpha. Load current is continuous. So this is the input voltage VAN, VBN, and this is the waveform for the load voltage for continuous current mode. Now circuit operation this is the circuit operation for continuous and discontinuous current mode, which we have explained earlier. Now pause this video and think on how to obtain average value of sinusoidal waveform given by Vm sine of omega t. Now answer to this question, let us go back to the waveform of the input voltage. Now let us consider Van, which is given by Vm sine of omega t sinusoidal waveform, and now we are interested in obtaining the average of this waveform. So for the sinusoidal waveform, the period is 2 pi. So obtain the area under the curve for the period. So for positive half cycle, this is the area, and for negative half cycle, this is area. Now area under the curve is obtained by integration, means we obtain integration of Vm sine of omega t d omega t from 0 to 2 pi. Now if sinusoidal waveform is ideal, then area under the curve for positive half cycle and negative half cycle are equal, therefore average, that the sum of these two area, will come 0. Now this is divided by the time period of the waveform, which is 2 pi. So in this way, the average of the sinusoidal waveform can be obtained. Now same method is applied for obtaining the average voltage of any periodic waveform. Now this is load voltage waveform for continuous current mode. Now if we observe this load voltage waveform, the period, this is alpha to pi plus alpha, then pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha, means this part is repeated here. Therefore the period of output is pi minus alpha, that is pi. Now let us make the derivation for average load voltage for continuous current mode. Now average load voltage for continuous current mode is given by Vo DC is equal to integration Vm sine of omega t d omega t, and the limits of integration are from alpha to pi plus alpha, and this is to be divided by the period, which is equal to pi, that is 1 upon pi. This is equal to Vm is constant taken outside, Vm by pi, integral alpha to pi plus alpha sine of omega t d omega t. This is equal to Vm by pi, integral of sine omega t is minus cos of omega t, limits alpha pi plus alpha. Substituting these limits, we get minus cos of, put upper limit pi plus alpha, minus minus become plus cos of alpha, that is equal to Vm by pi in the bracket minus minus cos alpha plus cos alpha. This will become equal to 2 Vm by pi cos of alpha, means average load voltage for continuous current mode is given by 2 Vm by pi into cos of alpha. Now these are the references. Power Electronics by M.D. Singh and K.B. Khan Chandani, McGraw-Hill Publication, and second is Industrial and Power Electronics by Devdatta Shingare, Electrotech Publications. So these are references. Thank you for watching this video.